Question 11 then is from Deputy Angus O'Snoddy.
Minister, this question relates to the change in the health and safety regime that's been brought about in recent years because of disclosures from whistleblowers and the likes, which has led to new changes in health and safety in the Air Corps in particular. And the question is if all Defence Forces and Air Corps officers are trained in the use of respirators and breathing apparatus in the context of handling chemicals and toxic material, which in the past was wrongly handled and possibly exposed people to poisoning and ill health.
Thank you, Minister.
I'm advised by military authorities that all members of the Defence Forces are trained in fitting of the General Service respirator as part of their basic training, and that tests of elementary training are conducted annually in a respirator test facility. This training is in keeping with chemical, biological, radioactive, neurological training that all Defence Force personnel undergo following on from basic training. I am further advised that by the military authorities that only those Defence Force personnel who are required to work with chemicals and toxins are required to undergo respiratory proactive, protective equipment training. Such training is provided to members of the Defence Forces in accordance with the relevant health and safety legislation. With regard to the Air Corps, I am advised that the Air Corps use two types of respiratory protective equipment, depending on the type of activity being carried out. Respirators, air purifying and breathing apparatus are air supplied. I am advised that any such personnel who require respiratory protective equipment training are trained as necessary.
Statement, but part of the question was when did it become mandatory, and from the last part of your answer it seems to suggest that not all Air Corps personnel are trained in the use of respirators, and kind of the other one is when exactly has it become or did it become mandatory for all of the Defence Force personnel to have that training, and is that training in full use at the moment?
Briefly,
regard to the Air Corps, I was advised that the Air Corps, that the people who specifically deal with chemicals are trained in the wearing of respirators. If they are only involved in dealing with these type of chemicals, and full training is absolutely given to these people, and they undergo relevant retraining and everything like that to make sure that they are fully trained I come back to you with a specific date. I haven't got a specific date, Deputy, but to my knowledge, that all full training is carried out in line with what is required.
Okay.